Good morning. Today we're in East Brent at the Church of St Mary the Virgin. It's a little bit windy today, but at least it's not raining. Hopefully we can go inside and take a look around. It's quite a big church from the outside. This is another church that's tucked away in a little village. Outside to have a look around the cemetery. Let's see if the door is open. Nice looking door. Right, let's go inside and have a look around. The size of this keyhole again. Nice ceiling in here. Nice lead base inside the font with a medieval sink plug, plastic one. Even the frame is really nice on this one. All the carvings on these posts. UNs were really interesting as well. Nice, very old looking carvings. You can pause all this and read at your own leisure. So, 10 Commandments. This must be the way up to the bell tower. Door's locked, so we can't go inside and have a look. So my camera is dirty, so the glass in the window is a bit misty. These pews look really old. Right, let's go down this side first and have a look. Look at these lights. back of the main entrance to the door. I wonder what it says on there. Oh. Just asking you to shut the door when you leave. I wonder who this was. He looked like some kind of priest or monk. What an interesting church. I've been in a lot of different churches filming. In each church I go in, there's always something different and interesting. And every one of them has a mediaeval fire extinguisher. Nice arches again. I do like those lights. balcony steps were worn over the years. The archway. This was where the priest stand to a service. Right, let's go back down. Nice tiles. Now, this must be a medieval radiator. I've never ever seen one like that before. And behind it says, the remains of R.E. Quentin Gent, who departed. That's all I can read. It's a nice window. Lots of nice windows in this church. Lots of colour. Look at the ceiling, the roof. It's one of the best roof ceilings I've seen for a long, long time. Wow, this is a really good looking window. Time has taken them to do this roof, and all the detail has gone into it, all the carving, all the lettering. I will add a lot of information at the beginning of the video for you to read. So you get to know more about the church. The road door. So now I'll have a quick look at the roof. I'd say a lot of work's gone into that. This is in memory of all the men that died during the Great War from East Brent. And here's the Second World War and Korean. Standards. They look quite old as well. Mediaeval speakers. Got a nice roof in there. Let's put the lights on, see if that makes any difference. And I wonder who this gentleman was. When you see these tombs of people just passed away a long, long time ago, it makes you wonder who they were, what they were like, and how they used to live in those days. See the difference between what I would call the old pews and the newer ones. These are more basic, still got carvings on. Maybe I'm wrong, but to me these look older. See how old it is, look at that. It's all rotted here, wooden. Oh, this is a really nice church. I know I keep saying that, but it's one of the best ones I've seen. All the detail in the carvings, you know, it's just wonderful. Right, I think it's time to go outside and take a look around. Right, here we are back outside. It's a nice day, but still a bit windy. Let's have a look around the cemetery now. We've got George Higgs there. He died 1898. And his wife, Louisa, she died in 1910, aged 75. Got this nice cross. I just can't make that out what it says on there. It looks like it's actually in Latin, maybe. Let's see if anything else is around the other side. This is the back of it. This grave's nearly buried. And all I can really make out on this one, somebody died in 1762 and somebody else died 1777. This is to the memory Lucy Elizabeth. Looks like she died in 1895, aged 50. This one's, I don't know if he's fallen over or is he meant to be like that. Nice big oak tree. Cemetery's well looked after. Grass is kept nice and short. They left this bit for the wildlife. We got John Kent. He died 1854, age 54. John Kent. He died 1851, age 76. And her daughter, Anne, she died 1885, age 56. Good. John Arney died 1822, age 40. Jane Arney, she died 1859, age 39. William Emery, Okay. Oh, that. William Memory, dearly loved son of Edwin and Bats Jarvis of this parish. He died 1883, aged 21. We got William Henry Daveridge. That's all it says on there. Oh, hell. Died December 1876. Then we got age 39 years. Grave. There's one all overgrown. This is a metal headstone. It's all rusted. I can't really read what it says on there. We've got a Mary Summers, is it? She died in 1886, age 73. A lot of these graves are so old, they're really worn. We have a John Mears. He died in East Brent in 1867, aged 62 years old. Harriet Curtin, who died 1888, aged 72. Also her husband George, he died 1902, aged 83. Again, that's some newer graves up there. And we got to the memory of Edmund Himmel, son of John, died 1866, aged 15 years. And we got John Isaac, father of the above. He died 1897, aged 78 years. And the other ones are a bit too faded to read. Then we have Elmer Ware. She died in 1915, aged 69. Also Anne Bamwell, mother of the above. She died 1890, aged 72. And John Bamwell, he died 1903, aged 83. It's a really nice church, this. So pleased I found it. Then we have a George Bamwell. He died 1876. Also, Nancy, his wife, she died 1902, aged 78. We have Isaac Broly. He died 1885, aged 38. We also have William Brooks, died 1900. Elizabeth Ann, she died 1941, aged 92. Around the back of the church. I was just talking to a lady about Erin on the grave where it's got the shape of a man lying in state. She said the story goes he was up on the top of the church cleaning it one day and he fell off and it died. And at the very bottom of his feet, there's supposed to be his dog lying there under his feet. She said that's what she was told when she was young. Whether it's true or not, she says she didn't know. It's a nice little story. We have Archdale Palmer Wickham, Vicar of East Brent from 1911 to 1935, and his wife Harriet Elizabeth Amy 1864 to 1940, is that? Well, besides the wind, it's a nice day. I really enjoyed looking around this church. So much to see, so many interesting bits to look at. I wonder what used to be there in the wall. Was it another window, or was there steps up to it? Was there a step up to it, or was that then to another door, who knows. I hope you enjoyed having a little round this church with me. And that's just about it, really. So thanks for joining me in this walk. Let's do some more history. St Mary's Virgin Church in East Britain. Thank you very much. Bye then.